To create a website, go to Sites. Here you have landing pages. Make sure you're in the Websites tab. I have one created here, and if you want to create a new one, just click Create Website. Give your site a name. I'm just going to call it Site for now. I can change that later. Save and continue. Choose a group or a couple of groups that will work with any form you create within your website and click Save and continue. Choose one of these templates. I'm going to go with the gym template here. Click Select. And here we go. This is what your website's visitors will see on the left. And on the right, we have different settings and different blocks you can use to build your site further. On the top, you have the navigation. We're on the home page. We have some preset pages for this template. We have who we are page, workouts, contact us, not found, and the password protection. You can password protect your pages, and you can design the password protection part of the page right here. And then once you click manage pages, you'll move on to the pages over here. We'll go back to that in a moment, but let's go back to these blocks and just have a really quick look at these blocks. I'll start with a text block. This is a universal text block. That means that you can write a lot of text, and then you can design the text by highlighting parts of the text, like if you want to bold it, or if you want to make it a title, all you do is highlight the whole part, choose format, and go into heading. Then, of course, you can align it to the center, change the color if you like, and play around with it. You can also just write a longer piece of text here. And then if you don't like how wide the text is, you can go ahead and click that block and go into the settings here. And in the setting, you can make the block go medium, or you can go narrow with the whole block. I usually use medium or narrow because I just like how easy it is to read narrower text. Then of course you can change the color of the heading, the color of the text from here. For example, if you also want it blue. And all your settings for this block are over here. Let's go to background. You can change that too. Make it a little more gray. And then this was the edit button here, but you can also duplicate this. Then you can also delete if you want. You can drag and drop by using this little button here. For example, you want this to go lower. Or you can use these arrows to make things move up and down. Now, you also don't have to move into these blocks here. If you want, you can just use this plus button and add things straight from here, like if you want to divider. And with the divider, it's similar. Just click Edit. You can change the style of the divider, the color if you want, and you can make the design a little bit different by using all these buttons over here. Make it bigger, smaller, whatever you like. But I'm going to cancel this, and I'm going to delete this little divider. The spacer is exactly what it says. You can space blocks between each other, make the space a little larger between them. I'm going to save this. Now the small image and content, and this is actually what has been used here. So I'm not actually going to add a new one. I'm just going to use this block here. I'm just going to click the edit button and show you what's possible. You can have the picture on the left, but let's say you want it on the right side. Right? Well, normally you would have to create a whole new block, but within MailerLite, it's pretty easy. You just click right, let's say, and you want this to be on the left. And let's say you want this to go on the top. There you go. Really quickie, really, really quick, really easy. If you don't like the buttons, you can also go into these buttons and, you know, not include them. Very easy. Once you're ready with this, just click save. And let's go into some of these other blocks, like the testimonials here. Now, these will move as a carousel once you start adding more and more of these testimonials. Let's add a new one here. Let's go with this image over here. And let's add another image here from our favorite dog here. There we go. And then, of course, you're not going to see many of the things that you add here dynamically. But if you go into the preview, let's do that here. Oh, let's say that. Sometimes you need to save that in order to see it in the preview. And here we go. If you go to the testimonials, we wait a little and then we see that carousel move on. You have the mobile view over here. If you want, you can have a look at that. And once you're done, you just click this little X button. All right, and the next thing we have is a one column content. It's not going to look too good, and I'm not going to be building it out. It would just take too much time, but I just wanted to show you really quickly. You have the button, you have the text here, and with this edit button, you have the options to not include the button or create a video instead of an image. In the settings, you have all the different options to style this. Like you can style the button, of course, change it into a different color, change the position of the button, and save that. Another thing worth mentioning is this history. You have different versions, and if you save and publish this, you will see more versions. For now, there are no versions in here. And for example, if you make too big of a mess, you can undo some of the things. You can even go back in time. Let's go to the very bottom and click undo. This will take us all the way back. There we go. All the changes have been reversed now. Then we have two columns, very simple, similar to one column, but you get two columns. And with three columns, it's very similar. Just get three columns instead of two for all your content. Let me just delete all of this here. You can delete columns also, as you see, and then trash it. Then we have their buttons, very self-explanatory. And in many cases, you can also link the buttons to some pretty cool things. For example, you can have it go to an external page and it will open in a new window. I like always setting that here. Or you can link it to another page, a pop-up that you create within MailerLite, a landing page, or an anchor. And what anchors do is, for example, I don't have any anchors here, but I'm going to leave that. Later, I'm going to add an anchor, and I'm going to show you what you can actually do with those anchors. I'm going to call it bottom. You probably don't want a button like this on your website, but just so I can show you what you can do. Then you got social links, and we got many of these links here. If you click these, you'll see how many different types are added. In the settings, you can also change the colors of these. For example, if you don't want them to be black, you can have it colorful. And if you go and click one of these little tabs here, one of these little items here, you can search for the social media network you're using. And we really have a lot of these. Now let's click save and leave this. And then the social sharing, of course, this is for people to find you on other social networks. And this is for people just so they can easily share your website. Then we have the image, very simple, an image carousel, which will start moving after you add images. Now you just have to make sure you add the images that are the same size. I added one, but actually you can, instead of adding one, you can select multiple images here and then just use this add all selected. There we go. And this carousel will start moving. Of course, you're not going to see it here. You'll need to use the preview. But basically these images, just make sure they're the same size. Basically these images will move around. In the settings, you can make it smaller again. And you have some little things that you can change, like the color of the indicator. And you can adjust the block height to the screen size. So any screen someone is using, this block will be full screen on that specific screen. So you can use that sometimes if needed for your design. I'm going to save this. I like the image gallery more than the carousel. I'm not too big of a fan of the carousels. So with the image gallery, you can do the same thing. Click here, choose your images. Let's use these pups here. Just select the ones you want to use, and then you can go ahead and add all selected here. This is how it looks. If you're using the grid view, and you have to wait a little for these to start loading. And if you want to change the grid view, you can also have an inline view, and it looks more like this. Very similar to what you'll see at the bottom here. This is an image gallery, right? And you can see how they pop out. And once they are on the website and you click one of these images, they will also show up in a very nice light box that people just can change to the next image by using the little arrow button. Okay, and you can, of course, change the arrangement of these images, delete some if you don't like some, change the images per line. For example, you can have 5, 4, 3, or 2 in one line. And once you're done with this, just go ahead and save. There we go. Then we have the signup form, just a simple signup form. You can edit to your liking. Of course, change the size of the image here once you upload the image. And you also have different types of settings for this contact form. You have a success page, a little success message, sorry. You can edit it here. And you also have all the things that you want to add to the form. Let's go back to the form view over here. And in the form, you can have you can add more fields like the name field, etc., etc. And in the settings later on, you can have also the content be a little medium or narrow or wide. And you have the different styling settings over here, just like in every other block. Let's go back into the content here. You can also have the video, of course, and have the position change if you like that. I'm going to save that. Then we have the contact form. This is just a way of people, so that people can easily contact you. You can add your email address here, success message again, and you can turn on or off that captcha. That's just in case you're getting too much spam. There we go. Then we have surveys. Each page can have a survey or a quiz. And once you use one survey, it will gray out because you can only have one at a time. And with the surveys, of course, you can add questions. You have different types of surveys, multiple choice, multiple image choice, open question, like, dislike, and a signup form. At the end of the survey, if you want, you can have people subscribe to your newsletter. Let's save that too. There we go. Then we have a simple countdown. It will count down to the time you set up here. Then we also have a map, and I really like this one. You can always put it in the footer, for example, or close to the footer. It almost works like a separate design. Very nice. And these settings, once you click this button here, you can enter your location. For example, let's go with London. Grill restaurant near London. Okay, that was from Google, but it's better to have just a specific address. Let's just go with London. But if you pick the specific address of your store or of your location, it's good because people then can click directions and their phones or their GPS will show them how to get to your location. And I also like the setting where you can make the map a little narrower so it can fit your design nicely. Then once you're done, just go ahead and save it. Then we have the Instagram feed. Once you integrate that, you're able to pull feeds to your Instagram block here. And your newsletter archive, you can also show newsletters that you're proud of. It will automatically pull the latest newsletters, and you can have four if you want in a row. You can also select manually the ones you want and the ones you don't want. Let's go back to three here. Save and continue. Then we have the table. This is a very simple way of just adding prices, right? If you want prices similar to the text block, you can just go ahead and edit these, change the sizes if you want. Then you also have an HTML code block that you can use. And once people are not going to see this, and once you start editing it, you can see this little text saying this block type is for HTML experts only. It uses HTML tags, and this page supports Bootstrap 4. Just so you know, in case you need to use that. You can use that for things like SoundCloud. You can embed things, but you need to know HTML a little, because if you're not using the right code from SoundCloud or whatever, you might get that. It might show up in a way you don't want it to show up. It might be too big, too small, or it might be positioned to the left or to the right too much. And then we have this anchor block. The anchor block is something I started talking about with the button. I can add it here, for example. No one is going to see this text. I can give the anchor block a name. Let's call it bottom. And what's going to happen is once I save this and I go to the top, for example, and I use that button again here. Here it is, button. I'll connect it to an anchor. This time it shows here. I save it. I go to preview. And here I can look through the mobile version. If I click bottom, it will go to that part where I left that anchor. Same thing with the desktop view. If I click bottom, it'll go to the bottom. Just in case you need that, it's there for you. And coming soon, Stripe payments. I will have an updated video for that. And that's pretty much it. One more very interesting thing here are the settings. These are the global settings for all of these things, right? So for example, if I want to change the buttons and I want them to be blue, you see this one changed, and most of the buttons will change here. You can also change the position of all the buttons at once if you want. but I don't want that. I'm just going to save that. And sometimes you see the position doesn't change because it will also depend on the settings available to us in those blocks. And sometimes if we change the custom block, we're not going to be able to globally manipulate that specific block. That's that. You can change, you can have the site be a container if you want. Of course, change the backgrounds, colors, add images to the background, etc., etc. Do most of the things you're used to if you've been building websites before. If you haven't been building websites, you can see how easy it is. And the good thing is these templates are very usable. Sometimes when you see a template, you're not actually able to make it look good with your design, with your content. But but with MailerLite templates, it's pretty easy to do, as you just saw. This doesn't look pretty good because I was just showing you the blocks, but I have actually already created websites, three websites, by using the landing pages. And with websites, it's even better because not only can I just create a simple landing page, I can also do something more, which is here in the pages section. I can go ahead and go into create new, and I can create a blog. Yes, now you don't need a separate third-party app for that. You can create your blog within MailerLite. And an interesting thing here is this setting here. It is in every page, and you can change the SEO settings, the social share settings. I really like this because I can use an image that I'm not using on my current website or on my current page, but that I want to use in social media. And this is what that is for. So I'm just going to click here. And to see, I'm going to save this here. And this is how it looks. Now I'm in the blog. To go back to the homepage, I just do this. I'm back. And in the blog, and we're back. These are just placeholders, so you can just ignore this. But this is how it will look more or less in the settings. You have some things you can go ahead and change. But also, if you hover over this block and click that little edit button, you can add things like set first featured image, show publish dates, read more, etc., etc. Items per page. You can have more before people actually see this little pagination feature here. And you can have like two items per row or one if you want. I'm just going to go with three. And I'm going to click save. And I'm going to go back to pages because I just wanted to show you one more thing. Here, each page also allows you to password protect it. You can hide it from the navigation here and then mark it as draft. If you mark it as draft, I would also advise you to hide it from the navigation so people don't actually see it. Okay, and that's pretty much it. These were the main features of our website builder. And once you're finished, you can go to the top right drop-down menu and click Save as Draft or click Save and Publish. And that's what we're going to do right now. And here are a lot of the main settings you can choose from your MailerLite domain or a custom domain. You can add one here. Some of the SEO settings for the main page. I'm going to go through over these. I'm going to go over these in another video called Website Settings. Just go ahead and look at that one. For now, just going to go really quickly, save and continue. And here is an overview of everything. You can edit it by using these edit buttons. But let's go to blog. And just really quickly, I wanted to show you this is where you actually create a blog post, add categories. But I'm going to go deeper into that in another video. Just look for the website settings video and for the creating a blog post video. Thank you very much. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. Have a wonderful day. And as usual, I'll see you in the next video. Hey, thanks for watching the video. Please click subscribe. Use the little bell icon. You can also catch us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. And of course, use the little subscribe link in the description to sign up to our newsletter. Thanks again. And see you in the next video.